like you're dealing with like a dad and his 17-year-old son yeah. who's like acting out.
I feel like Rocco's been ambushed in the sense that Rocco's operation was, you know, doing quite well. And yes, there were things that could have been improved upon, but for Trotter and his team to come in here like out of nowhere.
They've disappeared for 6 months and then all of a sudden,
we haven't had anyone and now we have everyone.
Resurfaced with a vengeance. But I just think it's sort of like the power struggle also.
Yeah,
you know, Jeffrey wants to be like, you know, it's my restaurant too, blah, blah, blah. But he hasn't been here at all, you know? Mama runs this place. Seriously, Mama runs this place.
She was busting tables tonight, by the way.
When people are like, where's Rocco? I'm like, what does it matter? I'm like, we got Mama. Mama runs the show here.
Well, no, it's a Mama.
Jeffrey was like on my case last night. The guy just won't stop. Well, he's like giving me this ultimatum that I don't really understand.
Ultimatum.
Asking me if I'm, he's like, you tell me by 6 o'clock tomorrow whether you're on board or not. And
what do you
I've
mean
been
on board?
Busting my ass for 8 months. I don't know what he means either. I kept asking, what do you mean by on board? What are you talking about? I said, how much more on board can I be if I'm here working my butt off? My mom's here, you know, dedicating her life to this restaurant.
What's my schedule today, JT? Listen, things are really coming to a head with Rocco, and I decided that I'm going to meet this chef that my friends are raving about. His name is Ralph, and he's supposedly like a wonder kid, a young, good-looking, personable, a lot of talent, a lot of energy. You know, I just need to start lining some people up. I mean, Rocco was completely frustrating me, and, you know, I don't know what's going to happen with him. All right, so keep in touch with me, okay? Thanks, bye.
Hey, Mom.
How are you?
Come. How are you?
I have a surprise for you. I have a videotape we did when you graduated 18 years ago.
That's okay. So cool. How'd you get this?
I asked your brother.
It's amazing.
And I asked him if he can lend it to me. And he did, yeah. And
I want to show haven't seen it since.
And I want to show it to you.
I don't think I've ever seen it.
Look you!
Now I know why I haven't seen it for 18 years.
Yeah, how much time do you have?
2 hours.
It's
rolling right now.
I was pretty skinny here, Mom.
Yeah, I know you were.
The Francis L. Roth Award for Outstanding Performance to Rocco and Dispirito.
Me.
Embarrassing. Grandma!
Oh, my bella. Oh, my God.
So I have to go up there and do a graduation speech for the graduates, just like there was for me, remember?
That's so great, Rocco. I'm so honored.
And they really want you to come, though.
I'm so honored to go there with you.
I'm hoping to find a line cook up there, so I'm going to go up the day before you. Just hope Jeffrey doesn't pull any fast stuff while I'm away.
I think you should talk to Jeffrey. It's all make the things work out.
Well, I just feel like I've been trying.
So you try to, you know, give in a little bit. He give in a little bit, but you cannot give up. I don't want you to give up anyhow.
Ralph?
Hey.
How you doing?
Good to see you.
Yeah. Just to give you some general background of, you know, why I wanted to see you, we've now been open for 5 months. Suffice to say that we lost money every month since we've been open so far. I've been forced to sort of go in and take control of the financial aspects of this business, and that has caused some issues with Rocco. I just don't get along with him.
All right,
Mom. Thank you so much.
Thank you. That was a great surprise.
Thank you.
I gotta go catch up with all my work. Take care.
Ciao, tesoro. Bye bye, honey.
Jeffrey Trotter, please leave a message.
Jeffrey, it's Rocco. How are you? I was just talking to my mom, and you know, sometimes, well, I guess all the time they know best. We got to do something about this situation. We can't continue like this.
Cooking to me was always natural. Never really thought about it, just know I liked food. It was part of my background growing up in an Italian family. What I do is every night when people come to a restaurant, I put on a show. And for me, it's instant gratification. In restaurants, I cook for you, you eat it, you either hate it or you're loving it. If you're loving it, it makes me happy.
Yeah.
This has to stop. So let's try to be grown-ups for a second, both of us, and see if we can work this out, right? So give me a call back.
I'm gonna wanna bring you to maybe do a trial so you'll, you know, make four or five things. Okay?
Sure.
Okay, thanks.
Thank you.
I appreciate it. Thanks for coming in.
Take care.
Okay, bye-bye.
Thank you.
When they fire table 8,
okay.
Could you just do that? Because I have to go talk to Luke.
Okay.
Thank you, buddy. Where do you want to go? Office? Okay.
So let me just ask you a couple questions. And by no means am I trying to be antagonistic. And I mean this in all sincerity. Who do you work for?
I work for China Grill Management.
Okay.
I was hired by Rocco Dispirito.
Okay, so what does that mean?
That means I'm in the middle and I'm, you know.
What can I do to help you not be in the middle? If you had any thoughts as to how that could be fixed.
How it could be fixed is for Jeffrey and Rocco to settle whatever dispute they're having and, you know, come up with whatever understanding and deal they want to come up with, because this is their restaurant, but I have to have allegiances to both parties.
If we're going to move forward, yeah, and I agree, I'm not trying to, we need to somehow align ourselves with the restaurant and not to the two parties. Mm-hmm. I can either, you know, you and I can do it two ways. We can work together, or I can get rid of you and I can sit in the middle of it and figure it out. Mm-hmm. That's a much slower, harder way to do it, because you spent months knowing the place.
I spend a lot of time.
Obviously.
Rocco's never here. Mama and I do everything.
Hi, Jeffrey.
Hey, Jeffrey, how are you? So, I'm a little perplexed because I'm not really sure what you were asking me for last night.
My thought process was basically to say to you, hey, listen, you know, whatever may have happened in the past or, you know, whatever occurred, you know, it's really, like, we're wasting a lot of energy on that. And you know, if we're going to do this project together, then we just need to do it.
I'm prepared to sit down and figure out, you know, how to do things if
I feel that you're making a good faith effort to really, you know, do what needs to be done here.
I have, you know, thoughts about the wine list and about the silverware and, you know, and about the lid. I mean, I have thoughts about those things, and I think...
These are things that, you know, partners sit down and discuss normally, but, you know, there's been nothing normal about our relationship
okay.
since the day we opened, so
okay.
I feel like I've given everything I can to this restaurant.
If you share information with me, I can try to improve things.
Well,
my job is to make sure the food is good.
I think the food is fantastic.
I mean, my job is to build a good kitchen and promote the
restaurant and market it. I think I've done an amazing job.
But the way
I recognize that you put
a lot of money into this restaurant and that you don't want to lose it.
You know, the number one thing I would do,
it would be to sort of jointly address the staff and say, hey, look, you know.
I'm all for that. That's a no-brainer.
Okay.
I'll see you tomorrow morning.
All right. Love the CIA. It's so beautiful. It's where I learned how to cook.
Great.
So you got Mom a car for tomorrow, right?
Yeah. For graduation, are you excited to give the speech?
Yeah. Hopefully I can share with them what I've learned and get them to really think about something. And I'm looking forward to finding a new line cook. Because a really good CIA grad is a great find. What's up, guys? How you doing? Sure. What's up, man? How you doing?
This is Mandy.
It's not in the back of my notebook of ideas.
No sweat, man.
Been in your restaurant the whole time.
Thank you, man.
I didn't know you went here. That's great.
I did, 86.
You did?
Yeah. Thanks for coming. So being our speaker. Yeah.
No sweat. Nice to see you. What's going on?
Nice to see you too.
How's it going? How's it going?
Oh, we're excited to have you here.
I'm happy to be here. Oh, look at the geese. This is a beautiful place. So you do
forno a leña here. Chef Sonschmidt, how are you? What's going on? Nice to see you.
How's everything?
My God, how are you doing? We're going to come up with the recipe of Mama's recipe.
Yeah, exactly, Mama's meatballs. I came up to show you how to do it.
I had it down there at your place at all.
Did you? You came to my place?
That's absolutely.
We came to Rocco's. That's right. I wasn't there then. I'm sorry I missed you.
What was Rocco like back then when you were his teacher?
Well, I don't want to say it, but he made the dean's list.
Ah, okay, that's enough. See? No more dean's list.
Why are we here? I have to do one thing here. There's an old tradition.
Okay, yes.
When a student and apprentice did better than the master,
okay,
the master will give a knife. This was given to me by my master in 1980 because I outdid my master. So I want to give it to you.
This is so nice of you. Thank you so much. I really appreciate it.
You outdid me.
I don't think so. I have a long way to go.
Maybe give me a job one of these days.
Oh, my God.
I wash dishes too, you know.
Thank you. That's so sweet of you. I appreciate it. Thank you.
So are we ready? First of all, you know, anybody thinks that we're here through next week and we're gone, okay, that's wrong. Okay, number two is, Rocco and I had a conversation and we agreed to work together on this project and we're supposed to address the staff together. And now, you know, again, actions speak louder than words. Rocco chose not to be here right now. You're gonna see a lot of things happening now in terms of uniforms and service items and things of that nature, which we've been talking about. Rocco and I have some conceptual differences about the way we should always do this. You know, we don't agree, for example, the silverware or things of that nature. I'm addressing all those. We're gonna address those kinds of problems right away. And this is a fun restaurant. It's supposed to be a fun place to work. You know, I never intended anybody to take sides. I just wanted everybody to be on one side, that's the restaurant side. If any of my people ever ask you to do something, which is contrary to something else you've been told and you disagree with it, tell them. Okay? All right, anything else I can tell you?
It's just that there seems to be this dust that needs to settle between you and Rocco, because you guys are the owners.
Right now, I'm the owner.
Right.
Okay? So is there any confusion now about what's going on or, all right.
Thank you.
Okay. Okay. Hey, Mama.
Yep.
How are you?
Yeah, I'm fine, thank you.
What did I say? What is it that I did wrong?
I didn't do anything wrong.
I mean, you know, I'm not gonna let this business fall apart. Just
no, no.
You know, it's funny, like, Mama's really walking around upset, and I don't know what she's upset about.
I know it's very close to her. She's very, very endeared to this, and she thinks that the whole thing's, you know, changing, you know.
I don't want to change it. I just want,
and that's what I keep doing.
But you can't, but, you know, you just can't keep losing money.
So this is where they do the practicals now? Chef Rasco, nice to see you.
Nice to see you.
Thanks so much for doing this. We need a really good cook, and I figured this would be the best way to get one.
That's a good idea.
Yeah. Is it cocked to the side far enough? What's your name, Eric?
Yes.
Nice to see you.
Brahim,
nice to meet you.
Justin,
nice to meet you. Ken, nice to meet you. What's your name?
Jesse,
cool. So I see you guys have your station set up. I'm excited that one of you guys will come down and work with me. It'll be fun. You guys know what to do. Grab your food in an hour and a half for one course, and I think that should be fine, right?
Yeah.
Justin, you got about 20 minutes. How you doing?
Fine, Chef. Thank you.
All right, then let's move it up to 10 minutes from now.
We'll keep it at 20.
So much fun. Raheem, you're up.
How do you think it works out?
I like it.
You don't think it's too cooked?
It is a little, I think.
Good answer, yeah.
Are you ready, Ken?
Okay, and what do you think about your dish?
I wasn't too happy with the vegetable selection we had. Haricot berries.
Let's try not to blame others.
Let's go, Eric.
Go make a little vinaigrette, olive oil, red wine vinegar, salt, pepper, and bring it right back.
It was a little dry.
Definitely helps.
Thank you.
No breast?
Could I have I forgot it.
You forgot it? Bring it over.
What did you learn from the whole honey vinegar or that whole experience?
It's kind of a nice combination.
What are the names of my two restaurants?
Rocco's and Union Pacific.
Okay, thank you. Appreciate it.
Cheers.
Thank you very much.
Great dish, by the way.
Hi, guys. Okay, so we have 250 on the books tonight. That's 50 more than we had last night. And a note to everybody, coat check is for guests only. Anybody who has their stuff in coat check at the beginning of the evening, do we have to throw it away? I don't want to do that. So can we just make sure that everybody's stuff is out of coat check? She's a miserable, miserable person. She's on a huge power trip.
About what? She doesn't do anything.
She's the maid of D. She treats everyone at the door like they're children. Her entire staff like little children. Amanda, can you run around? Put out the dessert menus. They haven't been put out tonight.
Over here, I have all the men over here.
I've been here many times, and I've always asked, well, where's Rocco? Where's Rocco? Haven't I always asked?
Yes.
Where's
Never. Rocco?
Never. I think it's you that owns this restaurant.
No.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, that's what you want? Okay.
Jordan is at the bar, right?
Yep.
Okay. He's made himself quite widely known to all of us.
Yes.
And Amanda, you know who John Jordan is too, yes? Is this the gentleman there with the white collar and the white cuffs? He has been asking about Jeffrey Chadra and Drew. Can you just let him know that neither of them are here?
That's what the maitre d' said.
Oh, I think she might be wrong.
Jordan?
No.
With the blue shirt, not sitting down, the guy that... And I thought I was being very clear about the white cuffs and white collar. The gentleman sitting at the bar is part of China Grill Management. His name's Scott, so...
I'd like to welcome back to campus 1986 graduate Chef Rocco Dispirito.
So my hat fell off 15 times between the kitchen where we did the practical and here. I don't know how you guys do it. Can I take it off now? Thank you. Okay. Earlier today, five very lovely people offered another, 5 or 6 hours of their time to me, and I appreciate it very much, and I think it was very nice of you to do that. They were all very good. Three of them were exceptional, and one just stood out. And his name is Justin Williams, and I hope that you will accept my invitation to come to New York.
Flabbergasted, and I'm floored. I didn't expect it at all. It's an outstanding experience, and I had no clue that this could ever happen. Where's Rocco, Mama? Where's Rocco been?
He's a busy guy.
This is because your meatballs are the best.
Wait, before you're hungry, you gotta see. You might not like it.
It's gonna love it, I'm sure.
Oh my God! Oh! Oh my God! Oh my God!
Very patriotic. I am Italian patriot.
Oh my God. Oh my God. I wanted some water before I faint.
Thank you. Good night. Thank you. Good night. Thank you. Thank you. Good night. Amanda, you're very come be part of the front door. I can see you always gazing into the distance. I'd like it if you could be a little bit more focused.
What's going on? How you guys doing? So far, so good? What's wrong? What's wrong?
Can I have a little talk with you later?
Let's talk right now. What's wrong?
I can't talk right now.
Let's go take a walk, real quick. Emily, we'll be right back. So what's wrong?
I honestly cannot deal with Emily.
Really?
I'm just a really sensitive person. She was like, you can't
coming in or out? Am I supposed to be looking at you and talking to you? Because I don't want to talk to you.
I would really like to do something else in the restaurant. I don't want to quit, but I would really like to train as server. I would really like to not be up there with her, like, to be honest.
Okay. Can you really, like, do your best to put on a happy face until we come up with a really good solution?
Yeah.
Just
can
please.
I just have 5 minutes to, like...
Absolutely, yeah, right. Absolutely. And okay. We'll work something out, okay?
Cool. Thank you.
Tough.
I love tough girl.
She will make you cry.
I make everybody cry.
Hey, Mom. How are you?
How are you?
How's it going?
Wonderful.
Hey, Dad.
See you. Great.
How's it going?
How are you doing?
Today's commencement speaker goes beyond the kitchen as well. He was named one of People Magazine's Sexiest Men Alive in 2002. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Chef Rocco Dispirito.
Hi, everybody. It's really a pleasure to be here. I want you guys to be really proud of yourselves today. And take today and tomorrow and really, really enjoy it. I want you guys to think big, enormous. Your future is this big. It's as big as you want it to be. Right now, you've learned the skills that make up your craft. As you travel in your personal journey, you'll find your voice. That voice is what is ultimately going to make you a happy person in this business. I wish you good luck, and I want you to dream your biggest dream, and don't ever doubt that it'll happen, because it will. It absolutely will if you want it to. Congratulations.
Jeffrey,
great.
Doing a tasting, I guess.
Absolutely.
Around 4:30, so.
So you know what the kitchen is?
I have no, I've never
all
been
right,
here
well,
before.
Allow me to show you.
What we have here is a ahi tuna served rare. It's basically, I call it a tuna bourgeon. Okay, guys, we have the traditional spaghetti and meatballs. My way.
It's delicious. Watch out, Mama. That's very good.
Delicious.
This is great.
Hey, Terry, would you buy the sauce if it was in a jar? I sure as hell would.
What we have here is a veal tenderloin. That's over arugula salad, caramelized fennel, Parmigiano Reggiano shavings, and a little aged balsamic.
This is excellent. Oh, man.
To be perfectly honest with you, they look like a very tough group of folks that know their food. And if they're anything like me, they're not going to love everything, but they're going to like parts of it. And hopefully they were hungry when they came here. Thank you, everyone, for having me.
Thank you very much.
Very good.
I thought 90% of the food was excellent. I didn't give many parameters except to make spaghetti meatballs, which I thought were fabulous.
Instinct. Comes natural to me. I don't know why. Some people paint, some people dance. I cook.
He's one person that I'm looking at, and I have two other people that I want to talk to, and then make a decision.
Graduates. I'm pleased to bestow a special honor upon Rocco. The Master of Aesthetics of Gastronomy Award is symbolized by this crystal pineapple. And the crystal, Rocco, symbolizes the sparkle of your passion, the clarity of your vision, and the brilliance of your career. So, Rocco, I'd like to present this to you also.
Thank you very much.
And now I would also like to ask Rocco's mother, Nicolina, to come to the podium. Now, as you may know, Mama is actually the inspiration behind the menu at Rocco's 22nd Street and is the executive chef. In recognition of your passion and commitment to the culinary arts, in admiration for your exemplary work ethic, and with envy for the quality of your legendary meatballs, I hereby proclaim you an ambassador of the Culinary Institute of America. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in congratulating Nicolina.
Speaking to people around the restaurant about me, which I, you know, I don't necessarily appreciate, but my main concern is them, so I'm not really clear about why it is that you, that I've been, you know, treating you badly.
It's just a general kind of negativity that I feel from you. I'm a little bit frightened of you, so I like to just kind of take my distance, do my job well, be on top of things, and I feel like I do that, and I don't want to, like, get involved in any kind of, like, confrontation or...
Okay, well, I haven't been very confrontational with you, Amanda. It is actually my job, my role in this restaurant, to maintain, you know, a very...
But there are ways of doing that.
Well, can I just finish? First of all, you don't really do your job very well at the front desk, and you know you're quite often absent at the front door, and I mean absent energy-wise and mentally. That's why I asked you to come closer to me to be part of the front door and to actually stop gazing off, because as soon as somebody steps through the front door, you need to be on. You know, I would have expected somebody who wanted to get further in this restaurant.
Agree to disagree, because I don't believe I did.
I actually don't really like the way you're talking to me, and you won't let me finish. So I was going to say that I would imagine that you would probably be quite enthusiastic.
I am quite enthusiastic at the door, and I'm sorry, I just don't see it your way.
It's fine, Amanda, just have a good night.
Thank you.
What table Jeffrey's sitting at?
Table 55.
Is Rocco here?
No.
Where's he at?
I don't know. I guess Rocco's a good guy, but he's never here.
I think I'm ovulating. I think that's half my problem right now.
Okay, 55 is Jeffrey?
Oh, two people.
Okay, order fire, veal parm, orchiette. He wants all of this, too. You said you wanted to cook for Jeffrey. Jeffrey's eating a lot.
It's my restaurant.
Right.
I was trying to work out something with him for him to work his way into it.
Right.
His name's on it.
Sure.
I can take his name there tomorrow. I got other people, you know what I'm saying?
That kid Justin Wallace is going to be great. He really has a spark in him that's interesting. He was so excited. I had no idea.
It was really touching to see someone who's still really enthusiastic about work.
You know what? Send us up some desserts.
Some desserts?
Yeah, just pick like three or four desserts.
Okay, fantastic.
Okay.
Hi.
Hi, I'm Ralph.
Nice. Hi, Ralph. I'm Carrie. Sorry. What are you doing here, Ralph?
What am I doing here?
We're
gonna do a new project together?
Let's see, under the radar, but
under the radar. Good.
Where's Rocco?
Rocco, that's a good question. I can ask. I know he hasn't come in here tonight though.
One of the good things about going back there is that it's nice to hear the support of the faculty there, especially after everything we've been through, you know. So what drama do we have today?
Rocco's replacement.
Just spreading rumors like it's Rocco's replacement.
Oh no, I didn't say that. I didn't say that. That came from another source.
Talk about Jeffrey. As far as I understand, what he's done so far is he's had his people make some changes. You know, some of them are insignificant. Some of them are, many of them are the things we've been wanting for 6 months anyway. But when he has a meeting with the staff and says, I'm not an owner, did he announce that in front of all the staff?
He didn't say Rocco is not an owner.
What did he say?
What did I tell you?
I'm the owner here.
So just so you guys know, once and for all, that's not true. We're both owners, 50% each. Okay, just so you know. And he doesn't have a right to say that or to do what he's doing.
You know, you spend some time at Rocco's now. There's a lot of things that need to change there, but I wanted to know from you what you think you can fix immediately.
The first one is uniforms. Because
yeah, okay.
It looks messy. We can't tell who's a waiter, who's a busser. So the guests are confused with what's going on. And after two washes, they looked like hell. Having real silverware on a table where people are having calamari out of newspaper is not making any sense at all.
So get some patterns. So let's make sure it's consistent, but let's get rid of it.
Where we're heading is ultimately going to be a legal battle between him and I, and the first legal remedy I have is a restraining order, an injunction against him, and I can do that, and if I have to do that, I will. I'm in possession of the restaurant, and if those four managers that are there every day start doing things that are irreversible, we're going to throw them out of the restaurant. You know, I'd like to avoid that kind of conflict. Obviously, I'm not a guy who wants to be in war every day. You know, it just depends how far they push.
Those bar stools, they're, first of all, we only get like 13 of them, I think, actually fit at the bar. They're extremely cumbersome. I know there was discussion about possibly bringing in like the pub style, like wooden stools. And I think we'll get at least four or five more chairs there.
That's something we need to change right away because that bar is not working right now. You can't even get by anybody to get a drink. So this will at least give us momentum toward like trying to save some money. So let's get moving. Okay,
thanks.
Sir, I'm all right, man. Nice to see you.
Nice to see you too.
Congratulations again on your graduation.
Thank you.
I want to take you to Union Pacific first, actually.
Okay.
I want you to work there for a few days.
Okay.
Because I want you to see kind of everything that we're doing.
All right, so let's go over there.
Okay. We'll talk some more. It's a little calmer at UP.
Yeah.
And I just think it's a better place to start because walking into that right now is like...
Right.
You want to know which end is up.
Right.
So UP is actually just right down the block.
Okay.
And I opened that place 6 years ago. More fine dining, more fish oriented, lots of recipes from the book. I think you'll like it very much.
Shot at the bar with her customers.
She was doing a shot?
Yeah.
Did you know that Janine was drinking on the job?
Yeah. Janine, have you been drinking alcohol?
No, actually I haven't. But...
you didn't have any alcohol at the bar?
No, what is this? You're the second, third person to ask me.
The girl isn't even 21. She's stealing.
Doesn't drink.
I know.
I saw her do it. Does she smell like alcohol?
I didn't go and smell her.
We need a word of you in the wine room.
Were you the one that reported it?
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah.
You little
close to go to Rocco's, but I thought it might be too much of a shock to go right drive from CIA to there. So I haven't started here for a few weeks. It's also a nightmare down there right now, so.
I mean, I walk in that restaurant, I feel like I'm in a stranger's house, you know? It's unbelievable.
Food looks great, by the way. It feels so much more comfortable in this place. This place just runs so well. I've had 6 years to work on it. It's everything I want it to be. It's just so much fun to watch all of my creations be executed by other people in such a marvelous way. And for the spirit I created to be just so intact here. I'm going back to Rocco's. I wish it wasn't so frustrating.
What ultimately determines what happens is what we want. People love you. You do all of that social thing quite well. And that's half the battle. The other half of the battle is organization and a set of skills that I don't think you have.
Like the table maintenance on table 55, at one point there was like a pile of napkins and empty glasses.
Oh, you guys,
only
I
two
sit
tables.
On every table, though. I mean,
I really don't think that, you know, we have a spot for you here at the restaurant after tonight. I just don't think we can invest much further. We've made this decision. Sorry.
But, cash out.
Steal our bananas. We need them for
I'll leave them up front, puree
yeah,
for you.
What are you doing with these?
This right here. That's what I think of this restaurant. That's have nice. Fun.
Thank you very much. Thank you. That says it all. That says it all.
Oh, God. I wish Rock was here to deal with this.
What was this about you saying I took a drink at the bar? I raised my tray, dude. If you want to report some bad news on me, make sure you ask me first. I'm really sorry, but if that's what got me fired, you have a lot of weight on your shoulders. Like, that's not cool.
All right.
Not cool at all.
Okay. Good night.
Adios. Don't come to Rocco's. The management sucks.
She's got some issues. I've never seen that before.
The stamping, the smashing of the banana?
Is that a custom that I'm unaware of?
I agree.
Good riddance.
She didn't think that we gave her any chances, but we all feel like there was...
Well, you know what? As long as it initiated the action, I'm happy with it.
Yeah. Just so you know.
That's fine. All right. I will never say she did a shot again. I'm doing the best I can. I mean, it's so tough. It's just hard to walk into my own restaurant. I never thought I'd feel like a stranger in my own restaurant. There, you know, there's strange people creeping everybody out. No one knows what's gonna happen next, and it's just strange. I don't know, I have to be in the restaurant tonight. I don't feel like going in. I don't even know if it's worth it anymore. I hope to see you later. Bye.
cooking.
Cooking what?
Trying a new sauce. What do you think?
Wow. Terrible. Can I give a hug?
I'm gonna be hiring you 100%, okay?
You can't let this take our restaurant.
No, that will not happen. That will not happen. Okay? We gotta work together.
Okay. All right, Mom. Bye. Bye, Mom.
Thank you, Sono.
We're just, we're here to just work on a couple of things, and we'll just go over some basic stuff, like seat positions, clearing tables and stuff like that. Like, you know, just pretty basic stuff. Okay. I'm gonna go start a pot of coffee and then we'll get started.
You want me to make coffee? I'll make coffee.
Oh, yeah, that'd be great. Okay, so somebody else is gonna make coffee. So, yeah, we're gonna go over seat numbers. So it's 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, blah, 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 so on and so forth. And position 1, position 2, blah, blah, blah. Ooh, coffee. Coffee's on table 35. We'll stop here.
Is everyone comfortable with the positions? Does everyone know the positions? Is there any area, like the banquettes, that people don't know the positions?
Well, we confuse sometimes, you know?
Hey guys, let's take your coffees and let's go this way because I know some of you have to be out here by 11.
Don't worry, Carol. We'll get this done. I'm just making sure everybody's awake.
Okay. Yeah.
Basically, we left off here
okay,
at.
Excuse me. Yeah. Guys, Buster's who Buster's here?
Oh, no, Carlos is good. Like, Carlos has been with us for.
There's not good. This is a Buster meeting. We're going to talk about some things that we want to work on to make you guys more efficient, to make you work better with the waiters, so that overall everyone makes more money. Okay? That's what this is about. Putting more money in your pockets, more efficient, turning the tables so we can move. Okay? We can get better at our jobs. So, please put down your jackets, your bags, and everything.
Carol.
Okay.
The best way to get things done is to all be friends. I'll be on the
side. I understand that. Yeah. I understand that. It's not a friend thing, Al. It's about I've got some direction to give them.
I know.
And I've got years of experience to back it up.
I absolutely
I'm
understand that.
I'm just here to give it a little direction, okay?
I
know. Pull it all together. These people have to be out of here at 11 o'clock.
In any case, so that brings us back here to the lovely back of the house. Now, these round tables are the tricky ones. Table 64
can
here.
Can everyone come over here? Because if you can't the see
rule,
it, then
the rule,
please.
Yeah,
please.
I know.
I'd like everyone to see this.
I know. Going over this in any case, you always want to clear a table from the guest's right side with your right hand. So you start one plate. This is your anchor plate. Now, you have your thumb on one side, your pinky finger on the other. See? Very stable. Move it around all you want.
I'm so mad, it's beyond me. I don't run meetings like this, Sarah. I never have. Hey, Al? Can I talk to you, please?
Sure.
Sarah's gonna take over.
I'm gonna sit and talk to you guys for a second. How are you? You look fantastic in that black shirt. Come to me.
This whole let's have coffee, let's have a social, let's talk to each other. That's
Carol, this is the way we've always done it. The best way to get this across is not by beating it into them.
But I wasn't beating it into them. I was trying.
I know, but what I'm saying is there's no reason I'm going to yell at them. There's no reason I'm going to conduct this in a
hurry. You don't yell at them because you're on the same level with them.
I'm trying to teach them. I was doing a very good job.
No, and you started off with coffee and tea in there. That's what you're telling me. They have to be out by 11. I don't think you're getting a message across.
Well, then we disagree.
Absolutely.
You know that the waiters are going to do the candles and they're going to do all of these things. And you can concentrate on your job. Everyone's gonna be held accountable for what they have to get done.
Rocco, this is Laurent. I'm coming over now. We need to talk.
Hey, what's up, Laurent? How are you? All right?
Can we talk in private?
Yeah.
I don't understand what you're doing.
I don't know what to do.
The restaurant needs you. People need you. The staff needs you. And right now, you know, nothing is happening because you are not there. They're listening to Jeffrey one day, and you know, everybody's confused. And I'm the one who is, you know, spending 15 hours a day there, you know, working with those guys. And there's only so much I can do. I mean, it says Rocco's on the other. It doesn't say Laurent or Jeffrey. I mean, it's your place.
It says my name everywhere, and I feel like, who the f- am I to be there? And I'm trying to figure out if it's worth even waking up in the morning for it. I mean, it's so retarded.
I wake up every morning for it, and it's not my restaurant, okay? I mean, come on. I mean, you know, the staff is still loyal to you, for the most part.
You really think I can make a difference if I go back there?
You have to be there, and you have to make the decisions. That's the bottom line. Otherwise, this place doesn't exist. You know, if you are not there, if you're not taking care of this place, it doesn't exist. There's no Rocco's. Whatever your relationship with Jeffrey is, you have no choice. You want to lose everything? I mean, what's the point?
No,
what's the point? You have to fight for it. You just fix it.
Honoring the veterans of World War II at 11.
Jeffrey, it's Rocco. Yeah, we gotta talk.
Pursuant to what?
You're not being straightforward about what your intentions are, and we need to meet face to face like two men to figure this out, all right?
Okay. You gonna come here or am I gonna come there?
Let's just set it up.
All right, then, I'm on my way.
Jeffrey wants a very standard pub Irish bar stool, but he also wants to fit more chairs at the bar.
Okay, so that's 17 inches. 3 feet, 5 inches, I guess? So we're gonna do 19 chairs total. You don't understand, if I don't have a bar stool by 11 o'clock tonight, Scott's gonna scream at me.
It's okay, if not, we'll make some.
Prima che vado via, voglio far vedere come si fa la pizza. In Italia. È un regalo mio per tutti, voi. Ok, per Rocco. Visto com'è elastica questa farina? Ho fatto 10 anni pizza. Per 10 anni.
Beautiful. Bellissimo.
Come culo di donna, eh? Come se... Capito? No. No, 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 non capito. No.
Like a woman's ass?
Questo qua facciamo.
Yeah, I'm good with a woman's ass.
Facciamo anche per dopo. Facciamo cottura sopra?
Sì. Ok, let's go cook the pizza.
Andiamo.
Thanks so much, bye-bye.
Their concern is like this.
The main concern is that we need 12 today. Something with this coloring, maybe a little bit lighter. Something basic, simple.
See, I can get it like pretty quick.
How
it's even possible I can get it this afternoon.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Okay.
Hi. Hi, how are you? Oh, all right, I've got a cherry wood chair here. How many?
15.
15?
$80.
$80 a piece.
Okay.
Thank you, guys.
Bye.
Good on you.
Bye.
Mom, a phone for you. It's Rocco.
So Jeffrey's here. So are you ready to meet with him?
Okay.
Okay, good.
Where are you?
I'm at the office. I'm gonna come over. Do me a favor. Can you find him? Go upstairs and sit him down.
Okay.
Great as usual.
What is all this mess?
What is the mess? Is Rocco coming? Or no, he's not coming.
He's coming.
Okay, well, should we want to wait? There's no mess. The restaurant's losing money. At some point, somebody has to show some fiscal responsibility, and somebody has to take some action which is going to correct the problems at the restaurant.
Uh-huh. Okay, who was this person?
Me.
It's you.
Me. I mean, what can I say about that? I mean, they need help. I'm trying to help them.
Before you do that, you should ask Rocco.
I did ask him.
This is what we need to talk about. Your perception of consulting with me and the reality is so far apart.
I don't think it's far apart, Rocco. I called you last Saturday, I have a conversation with you on the phone, and I said to you, these are the things we need to do together. I called you Monday to address the staff with me. You said you couldn't do it Monday. You set up a meeting for 9 o'clock, you move it to 6:30, then you move the location of the meeting.
The fact of the matter is, what we're doing to this restaurant and the staff is not healthy for the restaurant.
Truthfully, I think I'm wrestling this restaurant, and I think the people will appreciate it.
If you really care about the restaurant and really want to have a partnership with me, your approach would be completely different. And I'm going to make sure the staff knows I am apologizing on our behalf, yours and my behalf.
You don't need to apologize for me, Rocco.
I feel like I need to apologize because two grown men can't seem to take care of their problems behind closed doors. What you're doing to the staff is you're making them anxious, you're making them hostile, they have no idea who's boss here. I am here to operate this restaurant. You were here to fund this restaurant and operate the financial part of the restaurant.
Yeah.
Do not come in here and tell people that I'm not the owner, that they shouldn't listen to me, that you're the owner, you sign their checks.
I do sign their checks, Rocco.
That's not
and I am the owner of the restaurant. You have no right to tell people that you have the right to speak for this restaurant, and I don't have any say in what happens here.
True. You and I are partners.
Well, we're not partners, Rocco. We're not partners. That's the problem. We're not partners. Let's just litigate this issue, okay? We'll resolve it in the court.
Whose name is on the awning? Read the awning.
I can take that off tomorrow, Rocco.
Read the awning.
Should I take it off? How can I work with somebody who basically comes here and makes a lot of accusations that they can't back up?
How can I work with someone who hasn't paid me a dime since March?
I don't owe you any money,
Rocco. You absolutely owe me money.
Attenzione.
I haven't made a penny here since the day it opened.
I've lost $593,000, Rocco.
You know, your deal was to run the restaurant, and my deal was to run the restaurant. I'm supposed to get paid regardless of losses or winnings.
There's supposed to be salary if, as a result of hiring you, we save a position. But we didn't save a position, Rocco.
You just replaced me with five managers. You just replaced me with five people.
They're not getting paid.
It doesn't matter. Do you see how many people it takes to replace me?
That's
I'm
how many
the vision
people,
of this
Rocco,
restaurant.
Rocco, that's
I'm
how many,
the
Rocco, that's how many
of this
people
restaurant.
It takes
I am the marketing of this
to
restaurant.
Fix what you
I am
screwed
the
up, Rocco.
Of this restaurant.
That's how many people
I am
it takes.
The personality of
Rocco.
This restaurant.
Rocco,
I'm the personality of this restaurant, and you need six people to replace it.
No, I don't. I need six people to fix it, Rocco. Because that's how bad the situation you've
that's
created.
That's not true.
Mama mia.
The restaurant's packed every night. I don't know how you can say it didn't operate.
And losing money.
We are losing money, yet you can afford to buy new bar stools, which I haven't seen.
They're coming.
Charlie, how about you bring it in first?
Okay.
Yeah, Charlie, you bring it in. No one's going to come up to you. Let's start moving these out of here.
Too many things are happening behind my back. Everybody's nervous. No one knows who's going to keep their job. No one knows who's going to get fired. You brought your SWAT team in here.
You know what, Rocco? This is not your whim. This is not your whim to spend money. The things we did not pay for are things which you bought without authorization.
What I want to do is make sure that this restaurant runs well.
Yeah, me too.
And
losing $593,000, Rocco, is not the way to do it. I'm not going
to
sit here in front of your mother, especially, and have you accuse me of things which you can't support. How is it of my 20-plus restaurants, this is the only one that's losing money? I'm going to give you 7 or 8 transactions that you engage in that you need to explain, okay, which have very serious consequences. Okay, you want to do that? That's fine, and I'll be happy to make those public. So don't give me that horse. Because this restaurant, I don't need the money from this. I don't need to cheat you. You made your bed, now you lie in it, okay? You made your bed, now
you
lie in
it. Is that a threat?
You know, I don't need to threaten you, Rocco, because you'll self-destruct on your own. I don't need to threaten you.
It's not men. It should not be so
simple. Bring it on.
You make your own decisions. Like, I don't know. But I don't know. I think I can help you. Okay? I don't think I can help you. But I'm not obligated to run a losing restaurant, and I refuse to do it.
We don't want to talk about that. We don't want to lose a restaurant.
Huh?
We don't want to do that.
You don't want to do it? Well, then tell your son to cooperate in the process, as opposed to constantly attacking me every time he speaks
to
me.
And I'm telling you to not talk to people, because you're a big thing, he's nothing.
See what I said on the first
If you're really serious about us working together, you would behave accordingly, and you haven't.
you wouldn't behave. You wouldn't behave the way you're behaving.
Am I changing bar stools without talking to you? Am I changing silver without talking to you? Am I doing those things, or are you doing those things? Who's changing bar stools? Your staff. Who's plundering the restaurant of our silverware? Your staff.
I'm not plundering the restaurant.
Without talking to me. How is that cooperating? How is that working together?
How is it?
Explain how that's working together.
Well, you know what, Rocco?
It's not, Jeffrey. You can't explain it, and that's the truth.
No, I can explain it, Rocco. You're never here, and you need to respond when you get a phone call. I should be more mature. Okay.
You're not.
I'm not mature?
No.
Okay.
You're like
your son,
baby.
But your son's mature.
No, he's not.
Okay.
Both of you are not mature.
Okay.
Hey guys, can I have your attention for a second? I just wanted to talk to you about what's been obviously a very strange 4 weeks. I feel like I need to apologize for how the ownership of this restaurant collectively have handled what are first of all common, you know, problems between partners, but handle them in a way that's very public. And I feel like it's created a divisive and very anxiety-ridden environment. And the owners of the restaurant are me and Jeffrey, regardless of what you've heard, what you've been told. Hopefully we're gonna be able to resolve our differences in a way that doesn't involve you guys. Because frankly, in order for you to do your job well, you can't walk around with this kind of weight on your shoulders. You guys understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Yeah? Okay, good. All right, so if you need me, I'm here. All right? Thanks.
Interesting, huh? I'm going. He's gonna say what he wants to say, I don't care. Truth is the truth.
Okay? We're gonna issue uniforms for staff. And they're all gonna look nice tomorrow, and it's so exciting that something is going right.
So are we planning to get white, red, and green shirts? Or? These look really terrible in the restaurant. And I haven't been hasn't been discussed with me, hasn't been okayed with me. With regard to the silverware, I really like the silverware and I want to keep it. So if you guys are looking at new silverware, this is going to be a big issue.
I understand the silverware thing, but again, I'm just looking at it from the front. It's so expensive, and that's the only thing again.
So we have enough silverware last months and months. And you bring in new bar stools, I didn't even see a picture of them. I had no idea what's happening. It literally happened behind my back while I was talking to Jeffrey. I mean, how much of this kind of stuff do you expect me to put up with?
You know, I called you 2 or 3 days ago and left your message, and I'm still, you know, this is the first time I've seen you.
What other surprises are in the pipeline?
There's no surprises.
No surprise. Honest to God.
Okay.
Try it on this medium.
That's not your shirt.
Yeah, I know, but...
Can you do that blood at too bad?
I don't want to tell him that we're planning on moving the silverware to somewhere else.
Al, how are you?
I'm all right,
how's
man.
How's it going? I'm sorry I got yelled at for drinking coffee.
Yeah, everything's fine. I'm glad you're here, man.
Yeah. I'm here. Don't worry. I don't understand how we're losing money, but we can afford to spend $20,000 on new bar stools. We're, what, $1,500 each?
These?
Yeah.
$1,500 each?
How much were they?
No, less. We're like 100 and...
Oh, okay.
Like 110 or something like that. Right.
Rocco, I have to talk to you.
I work for Jeffrey, right? And I'm here to do a job for Jeffrey. So when Jeffrey says to me, I want you to go and do this, I go and do it. And the problem is that whatever is going on between you and Jeffrey...
No, I understand. So unless we're able to work together, we're going to be constantly mired down by this retarded situation. I understand.
So, and it's making me ineffective, it's making your managers ineffective, because I'm asking your managers to do something, and nothing's getting done.
You know, I'm all for improvement. But now that things are happening, I'm not hearing about it. And Jeffrey's telling people I'm not an owner, that's when he crossed the line.
But the silver and the bar stools and stuff are in the emails that were sent to you. And if they weren't sent to you, then Laurent has them.
Me getting an email and you going ahead and doing it without talking to me are way two completely different things. Hello? Hey. Okay, bye. I didn't get up in front of the staff and say, I'm the owner of this restaurant, you're supposed to listen to me. Jeffrey did that.
I don't think Jeffrey said that either.
Well, I think he did, so. He said it to the managers for sure, and when Tony piped up and said, who am I supposed to listen to, Jeffrey said, I'm the owner. So, if anyone created division, it wasn't me.
But you're helping to create the chaos that's going on here.
Absolutely not. Absolutely not. I've done nothing to contribute chaos. Yeah. Anyway. We can talk about this forever. So, I'm just telling you, with regard to this, I don't want to change them. Talk to Jeffrey. If he disagrees, Then I'll just have my security guards make sure they never leave the building.
Okay.
We'll just end up in retarded situations.
You don't think that's the most ridiculous thing? Like, I'm going to make sure my security guard doesn't take somewhere in the building?
If Jeffries insists that he has to change them and I disagree, then, you know.
So that's how we're going to play?
Well,
I'll get my security guards to come. I didn't set it up.
I didn't set the situation up. I didn't set this up.
But you're not helping me stop it either.
Do what you need to do. Make sure it doesn't happen.
Hey, JT. I need you to do something for me. I met with Rocco, and he sat there and told me he's never got any financial statements from us. He's never gotten any memos from Sarah or anybody or any emails about what we're going to do in the restaurant. So I need you to put together the following package, copies of all the emails, all the bills he sent to us, with a copy of all the, you know, canceled checks. You know, he's talking about things which aren't true, and I need to show him that it's not true.
Bring some spoons, Thorne. What's up, Jeff?
I just wanted to give you this. I brought you copies of the memos that Sarah sent to you, which you said you hadn't gotten. Here's copies of the Federal Express receipts signed for by Wallace Fortune. Here's copies of all the bills, which you said we didn't reimburse you for, which we did. And the wire instruction number and the checks. You look through it. I mean, maybe somebody else is keeping it from you, but it's not me, because I've certainly sent every financial statement I sent to Laurent. We sent it to you. I'm trying to make this restaurant successful. I'm not trying to make it not successful. Percentage of 100,000. I think we should sit and talk about all this stuff.
Yeah.
Okay.
I have a live interview now.
Okay.
And we have some.
Why don't you work on all this small stuff?
This is not a small stuff. It's a big problem for me.
I'm delegating to Laurent.
Right after the interview, I'm coming right back.
Thank you. See you later.
The squeeze bottles again. Never again.
Everything is going wrong. Everything's breaking down. It's like ridiculous.
Raise your hand if you want a shot. Customers are not supposed to be touching the bottles. Okay? Look at this. What is she doing with that poor thing? What are you doing to that bottle?
We're all cleaning up after you, and we're all, you know, I'm taking care of all these customers, and you're just down there having a party.
April. You gotta understand, that makes this bar a lot of money. Like, I'm pouring a lot of shots tonight, and we're gonna get a big tip out of that.
We need to have more wood fire. What's going on over there? A bigger fire means better food.
Upstairs.
Thinking, why don't you set up some plates for the guys? Do you even have plates up there for you? Dude, clean up your station. It's disgusting.
You're down there talking all night, and we're picking up
your
slack.
I'm making money all night because these guys are ordering a ton of
drinks. You're not making that much money. You're not worth the money you're making, all right?
Well, when Rocco and Jeffrey hired me, that was their express intent. We need more people in here. We need more of a bar scene, and that is a bar scene.
You know, the sprinklers are going to go off in a minute, huh?
Okay, give me a manicotti. Gabe, come on, Gabe. You have another manicotti coming right now, correct? I need another one. I swear to... If you give me raw fish again, I am firing your ass. Put it up. Put it up. Put it up.
I don't know what you're talking about.
You can talk to me like that.
Don't even talk to me like that.
No, you don't. No, you don't.
Get off the line. You don't know how to treat people. You don't.
You don't know how to work. Get off the line.
Fine.
I'd kill him.
Sonny, what's happening with the smoke?
I don't know.
Look, it's burning.
Here we go again.
Someone get me a fire extinguisher!
Take a sheet pan, cover everything. Move all the food away. Stand back. Put it down, I got it.
We don't have to evacuate, I promise. No evacuating here, folks.
The kitchen's on fire. Is it literally in flames, or is it... Okay, I'm here, I'm right out front.
You need a flashlight?
Yes, please.
I think I know someone who has one.
I'd love the flashlight.
Same thing as before?
Yeah.
Sorry behind the wall, you know, went up and...
What you gotta do?
Can they start cooking again?
Yeah, go ahead.
Hey, guys, clean up and start again.
Runners, pick up all the plates. Yeah, somebody pick up the plates behind the line.
We just had another fire in the kitchen.
Oh, boy.
Another one, same place.
And you're trying to have a nice, quiet dinner, and the next thing you know, there's fire alarms going off. These guys are working like crazy. I've never seen a restaurant so chaotic and crazy.
As we know, our grill is not working, so please explain to our clientele that the fish will be pan roasted.
Do you have any pizza dough?
What?
Pizza dough?
Some semolina?
So what if I stood here and made pizza for everybody all night?
Huh?
A little pizza goes a long way, even after a fire. I haven't cooked pizza in 20 years, so let me know, okay? How's the pizza? Favorito? Pizza, guys? A little pizza on me? Who wants some pizza? You asked for pizza, so I made it for you myself.
My name's Bill. I'll be taking care of you this evening. Fill me in. You guys all know each other. You work together.
Three of us work together.
It shrinks. Ask him anything. Sit down.
Yeah, Miles can manage.
And will there be a fee, or do we throw something off the bill? No.
Hey, did I hear you guys say you were shrinks?
Mind if I sit down?
What's your name? Christina.
Amy.
Amy.
What's up?
Deborah.
Hi, Deborah. Sorry to interrupt you, man.
No.
You were shrinking?
Yes.
I am a bona fide narcissist. But it works for you. See, that's the thing. Everyone thinks it's working for me, but frankly, it's not.
Oh, my God.
What is the status of the fire?
The chef actually was great about this. What happened was fire came up from the other side of the wall downstairs, and it came up through here. He knew right away. Tony.
Okay. Yeah, so is Tony here?
Yeah.
Hey, listen, no wood. Anybody who puts wood in the fire, I have to terminate because it's illegal and it's a fire hazard. There are rules for a reason.
Right. I'll tell you one thing. It makes it taste good, but it's not worth the risk.
Of course. I mean, for a little extra flavor, I don't want to kill anybody, okay? Nobody got hurt there. Everybody's fine?
No, I did have to break a hole in the wall, though.
Do me a favor. Break a big hole, okay? It's okay. I'd rather have a hole in the wall than have people get hurt, okay?
Okay.
Thanks, Tony.
Okay.
Kid.
Okay.
It was really quite comical at that point. I was like, where are you going with the hammer?
My partner, Jeffrey Chodro, came in and just blew up our world.
Yeah.
He got me to believe that I would we would do something, and then we didn't do it.
But still, you gotta deal with him in
life. I gotta deal with him, but I can't stand him.
Today's meeting was the most bizarre meeting because, I came in, I was loaded for bear. I had all this documentation about all the things that he said that was not true, all the memos he said he didn't get, which I have the emails of. He completely ignored me, and then he just left.
Is he here now?
I think he's here now.
Do you want to bring him over?
Yeah, that would be interesting.
Yeah, it would.
Yeah. Hey, Bill.
I'm sorry.
Can you bring Jeffrey Chan?
Yes, sir.
Wait till you meet this guy.
On this table.
Yeah.
Yeah. Rocco would like to see you in the back.
Okay.
Jeffrey, I was talking to these therapists and
I was telling them about our situation. They want to meet you. So.
Yeah. What is our situation?
Yeah, it's our situation.
So are you a particular kind of therapist?
Yeah, I'm a psychiatrist.
You know, this may be just what the doctor ordered.
In my training, learning that couples, and I'm going to use that word to apply to both of you in sort of the exaggerated way, okay? No, but it does mean that you have a commitment to each other. Couples are going to fight about three things. One is sex, the second are kids, third is money. So my question is, do you think he's ripping you off?
He could be.
Why should he trust you?
Well, I have no motive to do anything wrong. Is more money going to impact my life?
Well, it's all a game.
It's not a game. No.
It's like a game of, Monopoly.
No.
Once you own Boardwalk Place, do you stop there or do you keep going?
Yeah, it's going on 55. It's kind of funny because the three people are therapists and they all work together.
Really?
And it seems like they're kind of mediating between Rocco and Jeffrey.
Funny part about this is that you ask anybody who works with me, they will tell you I'm not motivated by money. It's not a
Jeffrey, stop.
They'll tell you I'm not.
Maybe not right now.
No, I never have.
You're worth half a billion.
Never have been.
Anybody who comes from zero to half a billion is motivated by money.
There's definitely a dynamic of some kind of envy.
I believe Rocco and Jeffrey are having couples therapy in the middle of the restaurant.
No, I don't think it's working.
Jeffrey, you brought in Charlie, Kenji, Sarah, Carol, Luke. That's five people you stuffed down my throat.
It takes five people to fix what you broke.
Why are you two so contentious?
Because I put in 8 months of hard work and I haven't received a penny.
Well, how would you react? I have 20 plus restaurants and this is the only one losing money.
Have you been over to 55?
Can
you swing by those guys?
What's 55?
Rocco and Jeffrey? We're having a counseling session.
If I was with him and I were to say to him, what's successful about Jeffrey, what would he say?
He would certainly define my success as financial. But I also think he would probably say that I've succeeded in a very difficult business. It's one of the hardest businesses there is. And it wasn't a fluke. Because I did it a lot of times.
Right?
That's about right.
Yeah.
And I would ask you, if I'm alone with Jeff, and I say to him,
he would say he appreciates the integrity of my work, the fervor, in my cooking and the quality I strive for and the levels of new flavors and my artistic value. I think he would think I was a success on that level.
I always say this.
And what's the
He's
problem?
Very talented. I think the biggest issue that probably we have, speaking now completely openly, the most important thing you can do to be successful is to recognize what you know and to recognize what you don't know and to get people who can supplement the things that you don't do well. I've helped some other like very talented people become very successful because they let me do what I do best and they focus on what they do best. And that's the way teams move, right? I get vicarious pleasure out of other people succeeding if I've helped them. I actually want them to make money. I actually would like to have a program where this wrestler can be successful, he can make money. Because you know what? Then I'll get my money back. Right?
I want that as much as you do, trust me.
Okay.
Okay, listen. I'm sorry I lost my temper.
Me too.
I asked you to work a certain way. Dude, I love you, man. I trust you. I've been working with you for a long time. The reason why you're here is because I respect you and I want you around. But all I ask of you is to please work with me, okay? I mean, having the station set up, having it organized the way I showed you, it's not hard. If you need my help, I'm here for you. I want you to succeed. I don't want to lose my temper. I hate losing my voice. Okay, can we work together? Thank you. Here's your man of goat. Okay? Okay, talk to me. That should be 71 complete, right? 70 out, Bass in the window with a spag and ball.
You know what the funniest part of the whole thing is? We really like each other. You just can't tell. I really do like him.
So that when do happened. We need to be back here?
Next week.
I really think we should do this again.
I'll give you my card. We will do this.
Give me your card. Seriously, I'm going to talk to you.
You always hate going into therapy. You always feel better leaving.
It's a fun thing. It's a good thing.
So we'll
talk again.
Yeah, okay. I will. You know, I didn't need professional help until I got to this place.
Oh my God.
That was weird, right?
Oh, I get a hug, kiss.
You have to get a hug.